So welcome back to this session. We were discussing the module 2 digital system design. So the next topic in this, binary comparator. So as we know that comparators are used to compare two physical quantities. So in general, the same thing here, we will be using the comparators to compare two binary numbers and to establish the relationship between those two numbers. So we'll look with the comparator details. So a binary comparator is a combinational logic circuit that takes two binary numbers as the input and determines the relationship between themselves. So that means, so as we have the two inputs, so the relationship between the two inputs, whether it one number is greater than the other or one number is less than the other or one number is equal to the other number. So a binary comparator is a combinational logic circuit which compares two binary numbers, and at the output of the comparator we are going to get the relationship between these two input values, whether they are one number is greater than the other or one is less than the other number or both are equal. And in comparators, that is particularly in the binary comparators, we have two types of binary comparators. The first one we call it as identity comparator, and the next one we call it as magnitude comparator. So the identity comparator is also known as equality comparator. Sometimes we also call as equality comparator or equal comparator. So the reason is that, so if you look at the first one, so this is the identity comparator block representation. So identity comparator has two inputs and only one output. So this one output will be high only when A is equal to B. So that is what identity comparator, as the name itself says. So if both A and B are equal, then the output will be 1 or else the output will be 0. Okay. So suppose, for example, if A is 0 and B is 0, so both are equal, so the output will be 1. If in case, so A is 0 and B is 1, so they are not identical or they are not equal, so the output will be 0. Suppose, for example, if the value of A is 1 and B is 1, then so what will be the output? So what will be the output?
1, 2.
Output is 1 because both are equal, so the output will be 1. So this is what the identity comparator or equality comparator is. That clear? So coming to the next one is the magnitude comparator. So this is what it is prescribed for your syllabus. We will deal with an experiment in the lab, as well as we'll be working on magnitude comparator in the theory as well. So what this magnitude comparator will do? So this magnitude comparator, as the name itself says, it takes two binary numbers and it considers only the magnitude of that binary number. It is not going to consider the sign of that binary numbers. Okay, so this type of comparator is going to consider only the magnitude value. So suppose, for example, it is we have the two inputs A and B. So these two binary numbers input, what we have, so the binary value, magnitude of that binary value will be considered. And whereas for this magnitude comparator, as compared to with respect to the identity or equality comparator, we have three outputs here. So whereas in case of identity we have only one output, whereas in case of magnitude comparator we have three outputs, which indicates the first one goes for A greater than B, and the second one A equal to B, and third one A less than B. So depending on the value of the inputs applied at the A and B terminals, so any one of this output will be high. So suppose, for example, so if A is 0 and B is 0, so which one will be high? So which one will be high at the output side?
A equal to B.
So A equal to B will be high, perfect, and remaining will be low. So similarly, so if A is 1 and B is 0, if A is 1 and B is 0, which one will be high?
A greater than B.
So A greater than B will be, so this one will be 1 and rest 2 will be 0. Similarly, if we go for 0 and 1, then
A less than B.
So A less than B. So that is perfect. So 0, 0, 1. So if in case if we are applying the input 1 and 1, 1 and 1.
A equal to B.
So again we have A equal to B. So this will be 0, this will be 1, and this will be 0. So any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Artha theory concept? Concept artha?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is what the magnitude comparator is. So a magnitude comparator is a digital comparator which has three output terminals. As you can see, we have the three output terminals, one for the greater than, one for the equal, and one for the lesser. Okay, so but it still has only two inputs, and the number of bits can vary. So in the sense, this A value, the value of A can be 1 bit, or it can be 2 bit, or it can be 3 bit, or it can be, in general I can say, n bit. Okay, so this is about a comparator, basic introduction. So a comparator is a combinational logic circuit which is going to consider two inputs, binary input values, and in the output it is going to produce the relationship between the input values based on whether it is greater or lesser or equal. So that's it about the introduction part for the comparator. So in general, I can say that an n-bit comparator can compare two binary values of n-bit length. Okay, so that is what I mentioned in the previous slide. So A can be a single bit, 2-bit, 3-bit, 4-bit, or n-bit. Okay, so but A and B, so it is going to compare the two binary numbers of any bit length and establish the relationship between them. So basically, where we use these comparators are used in CPUs, microcontrollers, servo motor controls. So in order to compare one value with respect to a predefined value and then to take some actions. So that basically we use in servo motor control. So we will be having a feedback loop, we'll be having one threshold value. So always we will be comparing the present value with the threshold value. So if both are equal or not, or if it is less than or it is greater than. So depending on the output, we are going to perform some actions. So that is where we use the comparators. So at first, so we have, as per your syllabus, we are going to discuss 1-bit comparator, and then we are going to discuss 2-bit comparator. So at first, 1-bit magnitude comparator. So how this 1-bit magnitude comparator will be look like? So a 1-bit magnitude comparator, again, it's a combinational logic circuit which has two inputs and three outputs. At the input size, the size or the length of the two binary inputs what we have, that is 1 bit wide. So the A and B can take only single bit information. Okay, so a 1-bit magnitude comparator has two 1-bit inputs, that is A and B, and it has three 1-bit outputs. So that is A greater than B, A equal to B, and A less than B. So the truth table with respect to this, So as we have discussed in the introductory part, so if both the inputs are zero, so if both the inputs are zero, the output which is going to be one is A equal to B. So A greater than B and A less than B and A greater than B will be zero. Similarly, zero and one. So B is greater here in the sense A is less than B. So A is one, B is zero. So A is greater than B. A is one, B is one. So both are equal. So any doubt in this truth table part? Any doubt in the truth table part? So is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So now from this truth table, we need to construct the K map. So ಒಂದು ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ನ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವ್ದಾವ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಎ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ಬಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಎ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದನ್ ಬಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈಗ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ನ ನಿಮ್ಮ ನೋಟ್ಬುಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ? ಫೋರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಟೂ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಅಪ್, ಝೀರೋ ಝೀರೋ ಒನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಸೆಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಂತ ನೋಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಝೀರೋ, ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಒನ್, ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ತ್ರೀ. So suppose for example, if I am considering for, if I am considering for the A less than B, so which row, which cell I need to place one? So in cell one, so in cell one I am marking one. Okay, so what is the possibility of grouping? What is the possibility of grouping? ಏನಿದೆ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರೂಪಿಂಗ್? ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್?
ಎ ಬಾರ್ ಬಿ.
Yes, exactly. So the expression for this is A bar B. So any doubt is yeah, K map yav riti plot madodu anta artha aita? So iga ide riti A equal to B matte A greater than B ge neevu nimma notebook alli iga baradu nanage answer helu fast. So video on madi ellaru. Aita?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you see. Dhanushvi. A equal to B again, Bandi Japa.
Sir, A equal to B again. A bar, B bar plus AB.
Okay, perfect. So, Aduna, inno simplify madboda? A bar, B bar plus AB na? Okay, that's fine. So, next to Chetan MC. Chetan MC. ज्ञानेश्वरी ज्ञानेश्वरी चेतन ज्ञानेश्वरी और केल्ता इदिया ग्रेटर देन बी गे बरुत्ते एक्सप्रेशन ए ग्रेटर देन बी गे एन एक्सप्रेशन बरुत्ते विमला विमला
Yes, sir.
A greater than B, any expression for that?
A, B bar.
A, B bar, yes, perfect. So, as you said, so if we look at the KMMs of all these, so for A less than B, we have A bar B and A equal to B. So, we have A bar B bar plus A B. So this is nothing but XNOR operation. So agagi XNOR operational represent madi divile. Adad mele this is supposed to be A greater than B. Idu A less than B alla. So there is a correction here. So this one is A greater than B. So for A greater than B, so we have A B bar. So this is what for A greater than B A B bar, for A less than B A bar B. So now whatever the equations we have got, so that we are implementing using the basic gates or the logic gates. So this is what the logic diagram for 1-bit magnitude comparator. So note on this fast.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now if you look at the explanation, so here, so suppose for example, so I am going to apply 0 and 0. So both, so here, so this is where we are applying 0 here. So we are, so not yet 0, right? Output we are 1. And here, this is also 0. So 1 into 0, the output of AND gate is 0. So whereas here we have 1 and this one is 0. Sorry. This is 1 and this is 0. So again 0 and 1, the output of this AND gate is also 0. So A greater than B and A less than B are both 0. But for the NOR gate, so we have the output 1. Is it clear? So similarly, if I consider if I consider another input, suppose for example, so A is 1 and B is 0. So this, so 1 and 0. So A equal to B will be 0, obviously. Then, so A where we have connected, A we have connected to here, this is 1. Again, it is connected to here. So the output of this NOT gate will be 0. So B is connected to here, 0. The output of this NOT gate will be 1. Again, this B is connected to here. So now 1 and 1. So we know that the output of the AND gate will be 1 when both the inputs will be 1. Okay. And then, so since both are 0, the output is 0. So A greater than B is 1. So is that clear? So like this, we can analyze our comparator circuit. So any doubt in this one bit comparator? Any doubt in this one bit comparator?
No, sir.
Okay, so I'm going to end this.